Right, I'm back. It's day two. Actually, it's day three. It's now Tuesday. We started this boat trailer project on Sunday morning. This is the second session, so to speak, and it's pretty late at night. It's about 7 p.m. I've been teaching all day. So Ben's outside. We've removed the rear axle, which is now here with the springs still on. We're taking the wheels off. Just undone the front eye bolts on the leaf springs and just pulled the whole axle out in one lump with the wheels on. I've pulled the wheels off, that's now on the bench, ready to be stripped because there's some new leaf springs and there's going to be, by the looks of it, new U-bolts to fit as well. Ben's just cutting the bolts off for the mud guards. We want those out of the way because they're only plastic and they'll probably crack and get broken as we drag the chassis into the workshop. We're going to have to bring the chassis into the workshop now, as the weather is atrocious outside. It's been really wet and windy and rainy and horrible, and it's dark. But as in here, we can relax. We've got lots of lights. It's a bit warmer. It's a pleasant environment. It's a nice place to be. Outside in the cold, bad place to be. So what's left to do? Well, both the two cross members are welded in. There's just the underneath welds to do. So when we bring the chassis in first off, we'll put it upside down and I'll do those welds. Then that's all the welding finished. Then Ben's going to clean up the whole of the chassis, all the remaining chassis rails and bits and pieces, grind off all the rust, and then the chassis is ready to be painted. And we've got three... Here we are, look, we've got, from the customer, three lots of paint to use. And no, we're not sponsored, this is just what he's decided to buy. And he had a special gift for me as well. Right, so where do we start? Okay. First one, called cold galvet, first coat. That's gonna go on first, and then it'll be left to dry for a period of time. Golly, that's light. Second one is that one, metal primer, number two. So we'll do that one next after we've given it a good shake, once it's all dry. That feels empty almost. And then the last coat, step three, is the top coat, and we'll stick that on. And I got a free brush, woohoo. I've got springs to do, so while Ben's finishing off outside, I'm going to be ripping the springs off the axle. I can't fit the new ones yet because, hey, the U-bolts are all chewed up. We're going to need some new U-bolts, so I'll have to grab those tomorrow and fit the new springs tomorrow night after the chassis is all painted up and ready to go. Doesn't take long, it's like 2 bolts. Easy. Well, it's going to be a long night. So, there's going to be some filming, I'll be doing lots and lots of editing. You're just going to see me and Ben doing bits and pieces. I'll try and do a bit to camera now and again when Ben takes a break from grinding and making lots of noise. And hopefully we'll be able to make really good headway. And by the end of tonight, I want everything to be done except the axle back on. Because I can't refit the axle because I can't fit the new springs. Not really. No, I ain't got any U-bolts. Okay, here goes. Okay, I was going to try and save some of these U-bolts, but this side isn't too bad. That's why I wire brushed it off. And I put some CRC spray on there to try and give those nuts the best possible chance of coming off. But when you come over this side, you can see that this U-bolt has been obviously hit a curb and it's all smashed and bent. And if you look carefully, this one is also bent. So it's going to be new U-bolts all round, which means I can cut them off. Yay!
Yeah.
Okay, well, there was a lot of rust on that axle. You saw me at the end hammering it all off. That's the best way to attack rust, I find, is to get your big copper hammer or something big and heavy, smack the hell out of it. That's going to break off any rust on the inside of the box section and get rid of any external rust as well, because at the end of the day, you're trying to assess the condition of the axle. Is it too rusty? You know, there's no point in putting the back axle on again if the box section's corroded so much that it's weakened a lot substantially and it's going to fail. If it's bad, it needs a new one. Don't try and hide the fact, you know. Ben's having fun. So the springs, the reason why these are getting replaced, well, obviously they're very badly corroded. When springs get into this kind of condition, they are a warrant fail. When you get corrosion between the leaves, forcing the leaves apart, as you can see there, there's a big gap between the leaves. There you go, look, big gap between the leaves. That's caused by rust further down. Here, look, forcing those leaves apart. So that's a fail. U-bolts. Well, there's one of the bent ones. Yeah, needs changing. Rubbish. Absolute rubbish. Okay, so we'll take one of those in and get those measured up. That should work. Gives us an idea. Okay, base plates. Yeah, I'm going to clean those up. We'll be able to reuse those. Give them a quick grind and clean them. Fine. Jeez. Okay, so the axle is going to get ground back. Not completely the bare metal, but to get the thick off so the paint, the new paint, can actually make contact with the steel. Rather than painting good paint on top of the old stuff, we'll make it look good. Do a proper job. Right, moving on. Bring it in upside down, weren't we? That was the plan.
Well, there's not much need
for that. I've got to weld underneath it. Yeah, I've got some welds to do. Just hold the end of that one now. See how much it goes. Trailer was 2.4, wasn't it?
Yeah,
2.5. Woohoo! So we need to bring it round, turn it over here, bring it in with the hitch over that end, and the two legs. One should sit there, one should sit about there. And it'll just freestand on its legs at the back. And the hitch will just put on the corner of that bench. Maybe. Or maybe even just put on the ground, it can just sit as a triangle upside down, can it? Doesn't have to be level, does it?
Yeah. Like the right Viking thing. Yeah.
Right, you're going to have to come. Oh, time machine. We're almost in. Just that we're against that outrigger there.
Are they wired?
No. So once this is in, we've got to come across. Because we're coming in at an angle.
So we want to go in straight and then to...
Yeah, we can't there. No, no, we'll be alright. If we move the time machine a bit, and then that will go further that way, this will clear, because it's almost in. Right, so your end, cross that way a bit. Hang on. Oh, get one. Alright, fingers.
because we have to go in that door, mate.
It's like a jigsaw puzzle. Yes, right. That was fun, bringing the trailer in. It only just fit. So I'm going to get some welding done underneath the chassis. Ben's going to make a start grinding it off. Right, you're in. Now I'm going to put this extension lead in the vise so you can't pull it out the wall.
Okay.
How cool is that? Look at that. Professional.
Until it rubs through on the vise jewels and electrifies the whole bit.
Yes. Right, so where's your welding mask?
You're not using my welding mask. Use your welding mask.
I will, it's fine.
I bet my welding mask is now featured in quite a few of your videos, isn't it?
No.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
I'm going to go, God damn, he's got a cool welding mask.
I need to buy one.
You do?
I can't afford it on my poor wages.
Mate, you can afford new tyres.
Well, it's gone to new tyres. It's a choice, really. You want to do this side?
Hey?
Do you want to do this side?
No.
Why not?
It's like Mark asking me to lock up. I don't get paid enough to do that.
thought you were setting fire to my ass with sparks.
Right, well, it was a bit dark the other night, so you've not seen the finished welds, but that's what's painted was done on Sunday night, and I've just finished doing the underneath bits. So you can see they look all sorted. Hi, Ben. Right, back to work. That was new.
When did you get a new one?
Just the cover.
Ah, when did you get a new cover?
I didn't buy a whole one. God, I feel like I'm gonna die. Jesus! Look at that! Yours is even worse.
Yeah.
Man, I feel knackered now. It's horrendous, isn't it? I sneezed in mine. Oh, hang on. Where's the cap? There. Jesus. Right, what time is it?
I don't know. My phone's not on me.
I reckon it's almost tomorrow. Okay. I'll give you a quick look round. That was probably the worst ever grinding job I've ever done. That was horrendous. 3 hours?
Yeah.
2.5, 3 hours, 2 people, 2 grinders, pretty much non-stop bar a cup of tea. Don't ever want to do that again. So, I'm going to blow it off with the airline, have another cup of tea, and paint it. And then I'm going to have the world's longest shower, I think. So, yeah. I had to do it inside because I couldn't see outside, it's pitch black. But with hindsight, something like that really would be a lot better outside. So if you get a chance to do it during the day, do it outside because everything in here is covered in a thick layer of dust now, including my lungs, actually. So let's have a look and I'll show you exactly what we've done. So we've all the old steel, so these are the new bits, the cross members, the trailer's upside down at the moment. Makes a good tent actually. Good tent frame, anyway. And the original chassis, the chassis rails, have all been cleaned back to bare metal. It's been quite a job. All the way around. And even underneath. Look at that. How cool is that? So now there is no excuse. It should last a million years. No, not really. Not if they keep dipping it in the sea. So I reckon it's time to paint. What do you reckon, Ben?
I reckon you're on your own with the paint.
Bastard. Oh well.
I really can't see this being done for Thursday night.
Right, it's nearly midnight. Really is time for that shower. Now, as you can see, or maybe not, but it's all the first coat is finished. I'll show you what the paint was. Yeah, so the first coat of the kill rust, what is it, cold galv is now on, and actually it's gone on really well, and I'm actually quite impressed by the paint. Not sponsored, by the way. It's pretty good stuff, but obviously, you know, I'll wait to keep my final verdict until the last coat's on. We've still got two more coats of paint to go. We've got the springs, but we've got no U-bolts, so I'll get those tomorrow. Ben's going to put another the second coat of paint on in the morning. I won't be here for that, so it's not going to get filmed. And tomorrow night, we've got to reassemble the trailer and give it its final coat of paint. And put the mudguards on. And rewire the lights. And then Thursday morning, it has to go to work with me. Then I can put a warrant of fitness on in the afternoon, and then you've got to deliver it. No pressure there then. Okay, that's it for tonight. Okay, see you next time. I can breathe again. I'm back. It's day three, which is Wednesday. Day one, Sunday, day two, Tuesday, day three, Wednesday. And it's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So I managed to get home from work a little bit earlier today. And in the early hours of this morning, still half asleep, I called into the trailer shop and I got four new U-bolts and some new base plates. Yesterday morning, I picked up new springs. We're going to fit new springs to the trailer as well. And believe it or not, the trailer's changed colour. That means that Benjamin has put on the second coat for me. And the second coat is that Wattle Kill Rust metal primer stuff. It's a different colour. It's red. It's good that they're all different colours because then you can see when you've missed a bit. Makes it really easy to paint on. It's still drying. It's a really damp day. It's been really damp here in Auckland for the last couple of weeks. So it's going to probably not be dry until late tonight. And I'll probably bring a heater in there and get the whole place warmed up so I can get the last coat of paint on as the last job this evening before I decide to go inside. However, in the meantime, I still have an axle to clean up. I didn't do that. I just knocked the rust off. I want to actually grind it back and get rid of all that surface rust and get that painted. Now that's going to obviously be painted. It's got to go through the same process as the chassis. Stage one, stage two, and stage three. So that's going to be a bit out of sync with the chassis, which is a bit of a pain, but such is life. And I've also got the rims, the wheel rims to paint. and they're pretty rusty. So I went out a couple of days ago, knowing I had this to do, and I bought one of these. Now, these are both fantastic and incredibly dangerous at the same time. They actually spin onto your angle grinder shaft, so you take your cutting disc off or your grinding disc off, and you remove both the outer and the inner metal plates that clamp the disc. And that thread is the same as the thread on the spindle that comes out of the angle grinder motor. Now, these things are amazing at taking off rust. They're also incredibly good at taking off skin and causing lots of damage to your body parts. So if you're going to use one of these, and you really can't use it with a guard either because it gets in the way, you've got to be unbelievably careful. And it's a good recommendation to wear some kind of leather welding gauntlet on your hand, which is controlling the tool, because if you, you know, rub onto your finger with that, it's just going to be too late. It's not nice at all. I got one of these as well, and these are about $20 New Zealand each, which I thought was a pretty good price, actually, a bit cheaper than the ones in England, I think. And actually, just noticed they're made in New Zealand, so here am I supporting a New Zealand company and not the cheap Chinese imports that keep coming in. Sorry, pet hate. Okay, so waiting for the paint to dry on the chassis. Can't fit the springs and stuff yet, so the plan of attack is to clean up the axle, clean up the wheels, paint the chassis before we give up, and then tomorrow night, which is the last night, because it's got to be delivered Friday morning. Yeah, so tomorrow night, refit the axle with the springs and the wheels and all that kind of stuff. I've got a bit of wiring to do because we've cut some wires to get the mud guards taken off because of the side lights. And deliver it. Maybe I'll deliver it Friday morning. We'll see. I'd like to get it back Thursday night. Then I'm not stuck in traffic with it. So there you go. That's where we're at. It's quite a big project. Because all the tasks have overlapped, I think it's difficult to break this into separate videos. It's just going to be one big chunk of a video. And you can fast forward through it to the bits that are interesting to you. Okay, so I'm going to drag the axle out, put it on the bench, and grind the hell out of it, basically. So welcome to some more dust. Coolio. Right. I suppose we should put some new valves in as well. Jeez, deja vu. Whew, okay. So the axle's done. And the wheels are done. Ooh, look at that, shiny. They came up really well because you know just how rusty they were. Well, just before I start painting, you saw me using the, that infamous wire brush wheel and how often it was kicking back. Yeah, they're pretty dangerous, so be careful if you're going to use one. Also, you need to make sure that you've got a decent grinder, because they actually, if you know, they can burn your grinder out if your grinder is not particularly powerful. And this one is 10,000 revs, and hang on, there we are, look, it is 1,100 watts. So you want at least a 1,000 watt grinder, because that just to say copes with it. And this this Metabu one I have had for at least 15 years, and it's still on the original brushes. Now that's good. It's been a really good grinder, and no, I'm not sponsored. It's a lot better than the Makita that I bought Ben a couple of years ago. That's nowhere near as powerful, and I wouldn't dream of putting a wire brush like that in his Makita. Okay, so I finished grinding for the night. I've done all the nasty stuff. The wheels came out really, really well. Very, very impressed with those. They looked horrific at the start. One of them's a lot more rusty than the other, so I have a suspicion that the rusty one was the spare, and the good one is the one that was on the axle, and obviously at some point it's had a puncture and he swapped the wheels around. No, I'm not going to paint the spare, not at the moment, that wasn't part of the job. So I'm going to paint the wheels with the first coat, paint the axle with the first coat, and then I'm going to go straight onto the chassis and paint the final coat, and then maybe the axle and the wheels will be dry enough to put the second coat on tonight on those. So tomorrow morning before work I can come in and put the final coat on the axle and the wheels, and then tomorrow night if everything will be dry and I can reassemble it, because I'm against the clock. Okay, that's the plan. Right, let me get on. Okay, it's one down. Right, that's the wheels done and the axle done. So time for a new paintbrush and the final coat for the trailer. Then I can go inside. Jeez! There we go. Yuck. It's done. I think it's done. Three coats. This is the final coat. Silver stuff. Excellent. We've got a little bit left. We'll need that for the other stuff. Getting late. Okay. Trailer's painted, final coat. Very happy with that. Went on really well. Unfortunately, the axle and the rims are not dry. So I can't put the second coat on those yet. I'll have to do those in the morning. Yeah, that's going to put us back a bit. Could do one with the axle really painted up. Anyway, okay, I'm going to sign off for tonight. I need a shower. All you really see me do is paint, which is boring, I think. So there'll be lots of editing. Although cleaning the wheels up was quite interesting. That was that came out really, really well, and one of them was terrible. So there you go. That's probably, after all that work tonight, about 3 minutes of video. Oh well. Okay, until tomorrow, over and out.